committee. Most of you all received your letters regarding the first ever summit for counties with defense installations. It will be taking place on March the 3rd. Everyone's kind of looking forward to it. It's a new summit altogether. I've been screaming a movie all the way since I got on the committee. Natalie Brankovic, she is the legislative liaison, and she briefs us every month. The good thing about this summit, if you go, we're going to be meeting with the officials, other counties that have installations in there, they're going to be there. We're going to have people from the Pentagon, all of that. This is going to be a span of a 4-hour type of a presentation, sit down and tell us about the things that we have at our disposal, or possible resources that our county can use to help facilitate our base as well as the county. I sent an email out, afforded a document, I guess a couple weeks ago, pertaining to counties and military installations 101. The big takeaway, if we choose to do so, is to get more involved and communicate more with you. Our USDA office, they used to be in our civic center area, but now they're over in the Bank of America. But we can go through them to utilize a cap in the funding to say for like our pay areas, anything pertaining to areas that the county might own. Actually, it says public lands, and be able to get some type of subsidy for it. So we have to, if I know we rent it out, lease it out and all, but we can just balance that and see which one would benefit more from. There is also options for those who have private property, such as forestry. Say like right now, kind of, they own a lot of property that might be near the base area that they can go through us and qualify for some type of subsidy and assistance as well. So it's just something to look into if we want to go that route. I think it would be worth talking to the USDA since we have them right here and just try to just find out what they can do to help us out, what can we help them out.
Well, I'd have to be honest with everyone and say that I depend a lot on what NACO's platforms are and what they're able to do from the standpoint of supporting counties nationwide. I depend a lot on that, on Mr. Marshall and him being able to attend those NACO meetings. So again, I would think again that would still be a short-term goal. We want to continue to do it. I also think again as we grow as a community, those type of things and that information is going to be important. But I would say that yes, we need to continue to support Mr. Marshall and Ms. Evans if she wants to get involved with
it.
Well, there you go. I mean, again, we need to support their efforts to attend these meetings when they need to go. So that could potentially, or it will have a budget impact. So my recommendation would be to take a look at those calendars that they've got, get an idea of what you do want to attend so that Mr. Pritchard and them can kind of plan for that. That's what I'm
saying.